Jaguar Wright has now made another shocking revelation about how Diddy allegedly pimped Justin Bieber out to men in the industry, and this much is obvious considering how Justin has been treated all his life by celebrities.
Listen closely.
You want to hear? Oh, really? My parents never gave me the sex talk.
Okay.
So why don't you give me the sex talk?
I feel uncomfortable right now.
Aww.
Why do you want to know the sex talk from a 15-year-old boy? That's pretty weird. Let's talk about the album.
Okay, what's going on with your new album?
It's a really weird question.
Things on blast, you know?
You want to say it again? You have beautiful lips.
Oh, thank you, man. Thank you, bro.
You have good lips.
Thank you, bro.
Wear condoms. Yeah, serious.
Harry, who apparently wanted to know what a Bieber butt felt like.
The Year Award at the American Music Awards and managed to shock the teenage pop superstar. She presented with Luke Bryan and before Bieber with kisses on the neck and a butt grab. Backstage, McCarthy joked about what Bieber jokingly called violating.
I did grab his butt. I'm single. But I think that's cougar rape. I did grab his butt. I'm single. But I think that's cougar rape.
So was the butt grab spontaneous?
Well, it better be, because that's just weird if it isn't. Yeah, you know, I gave him a kiss and there was a lot of lipstick, and then my partner Luke decided to wipe it off, and I was like, no, asshole, I did that for a reason. So you remember me. So then I couldn't help it. He was just so delicious. So little, just, I want to tear his head off and eat it.
Wow, I feel violated right now. Wow. No one's listening, and that's just fucking lonely. I'm so lonely.
Everybody knows my past now. My house is always made of.
Jaguar Wright has always been on top of Diddy's antics, as evidenced by her recent interview with Real Life Productions.
People, he's having enough money to check.
He put the boots to that girl. She's supposed to be a good bitch. No matter who she with. All the time he putting a groom in her. Of course he thought it was still gonna work. He thinks he's God.
Fine.
Ain't doing shit. Raped the fuck out of that bitch. Put the boots to her last time I seen her. Fuck her and her trainer boyfriend, husband. I don't get no.
So you hear about stories of Diddy like shooting people,
yeah.
Blowing up cars.
Yeah.
Is he this gangster that behind the scenes that ever? Is that him or is that?
Shout out
running?
To Wendy Williams, the first woman to uncover. The homo thugs. That's what these down low bitches was called when Wendy first started talking about it in the 90s. The homo thug. She talking about Diddy.
And then what's the stuff that's happening to Wendy Williams? You think this is all connection to?
Of course. They've been waiting. He's been waiting. He was waiting for Kim. Remember? He was waiting. The casket was ready. She was literally casket ready.
You think that audio that they put out was real?
Yeah, that was real. Nikki put that out there. That Nikki recorded that at the freak off in the Calabasas. Man. She been waiting to drop that shit on Meek.
Oh, man.
She just wasn't going to tell nobody it was Diddy. But now that Diddy out there, why not?
So then who's the guy who's claiming he recorded it?
Oh, somebody that got paid?
Yeah, he said, like, I was standing outside
the door.
Yeah,
somebody that got paid.
Yeah.
Just like it wasn't seminal fluid. That Justin Bieber was wiping away from his mouth when he brought his face up from Odell Beckham's groin in a club with Trey Songz on the lookout.
The images are there.
Diddy Fi. Hashtag no Diddy.
Hashtag no Diddy. No Diddy. Do you have any views on Usher? Because a lot of things have come back to where
Usher.
They talk about his
Usher. I'm tired of Usher.
Oh, okay.
Goofy bitch.
No.
Got your asshole ripped open and the only thing it inspired was loyalty. They ripped your ass open. Gene didn't say it. He said, check the records at the hospital. I'm saying it. You got your ripped open. Then you take Justin Bieber from Lily White, Canada, and take him to the Flavor of Fuck Off, the Kitty Edition. Get his ripped open. Now
you said no Diddy, but it seems like there is Lil Rod has come out, who he produced the Love album, and it seems like he has recordings, pictures of a whole year and
smart
a half.
Smart guy.
Year and a half with Diddy, not getting paid to where
smart
he's like.
Smart guy.
It seems like you can't say no to Diddy the way he's putting it out. Like, there's a lot of people like, why didn't he say no?
Yeah, that you don't go.
Yes.
You don't go. Simple. Why go? They gonna drug you.
Laced, yeah.
You gonna ask for a glass of water, it's gonna be laced with that Tusi. Let the good times roll. Like, if I knew that there's a possibility that I might get raped and drugged if I go to this party, and I go anyway, I just wish they would tell all these little niggas.
I mean, there's also the fact that Diddy was making Jay and allegedly drink alcohol when he was a minor.
All the champagne was spiked, son. Like, all the champagne was spiked. Everybody was passed the fuck out. I don't drink, so I was playing that shit off like I don't fucking drink. I smoke, nigga. Like, I smoke and I had my own weed, but, like, everybody was passed out. Yo, Diddy had that man in the room. Look, yes, I put my ear to the fucking door and I brought the phone because Diddy started going in overdrive. I ain't know what the fuck was going on, but I just heard balls slapping against ass cheeks. I heard niggas struggling to take dick. I heard niggas being like, yeah, Daddy. Like, when he started all that daddy this and daddy that. And then I heard some hollering and struggling like, yeah, I kept the phone there and I recorded all that shit because I was like, this nigga Diddy rich. So I'm finna put the squeeze on and get me a couple dollars and just say, you know what I'm saying? Just nobody believed that was really Diddy beating me back in. But now y'all motherfuckers believe the video, right? Right? Somebody throw me a couple dollars.
And when you consider the ways he has tried to groom and manipulate Justin in the past, it should not at all be surprising what is happening now.
What's up, man? You good?
I'm good. How are you? All
right, young brother, everything's good? Selling out arenas and everything? Yeah. Starting to act different, huh? You ain't been calling me and hanging out the way we used to hang out.
Well, I mean, you try to get in contact with me, you know, through all my, you know, partners and whatnot.
Mm-hmm.
But you never really got my number, so.
Right, okay.
My number?
Yeah.
I'm gonna tell you my number.
Yeah.
555.
Man.
Woo. Okay.
Okay.
All right, so I'm gonna be driving this next year.
Yeah, when you get 16, you come down and you gotta, you know, wear your seat.
I mean, I'm 15, you can ride in the passenger seat. I got my permit. Not yet.
No, 16. You're not ready. Slow down, Josh. Okay. And slow down, okay?
One step at a time.
But yeah, the keys is yours when you get 16. You're good to go.
I'm good to go.
Yeah.
All right.
And then when you get 18, you get the house. You get the mansion.
Okay. I get the mansion? Yeah. All right. So where are we off to now?
Where would you like to go?
Wherever you want
to
go.
Check this out, yo. Justin, you ever seen the movie 48 Hours? Right now, he's having 48 hours with Diddy, him and his boy. They're having the times of their lives, like, you know, where we hanging out and what we doing. we can't really disclose, but it's definitely a 15-year-old's dream. You know, I have been given custody of him. You know, he signed to Usher.
I'm signed to Usher.
I had legal guardianship of Usher when you know he did his first album. I did Usher's first album. I don't have legal guardianship of him, but for the next 48 hours, he's with me. So and we gonna go full. Buck full crazy.
We're going crazy.
Crazy.
I'm taking this out tonight.
What you wanna do? What you wanna do over the next 48 hours?
48 hours. Let's go, let's just go get some girls. Let's go hang out some girls.
A man after my heart. That's what I'm talking about, kid.
When you consider that Diddy has quite a lot of connections in the industry, it becomes quite apparent that his network and power extend a lot further than we always thought.
She saw no way out other than doing what he told her to do. He had mentally controlled her. He it's like a pimp. Diddy had pimp potential. He had her mind messed up where it controlled her. She felt no way out. She felt like if she walked out the door, he wasn't gonna do the music no more. If she went somewhere or she ran and didn't wanna do that, their relationship not only would have been over, he would have painted a picture that nobody else in the industry would have dealt with her. I said Wendy Williams. He said it when he was in Cali. When I come back to New York and that B-I-T-C-H is on the radio. This is Wendy Williams, the hottest radio host in New York City. When she put out those pictures of the dude pulling his pants down, and it looked like some gay act that was going on. He got on the phone. He said, let me tell you this. When I get back to New York City, if she's on the radio station, he's talking to a radio executive. He said the same thing. He said, nobody that I deal with, nobody that I know is going to do anything with y'all. No business at all. It ain't gonna be no artists, no nothing gonna come. He's telling people that at a radio station. When we got back to New York City, Wendy Williams was in Philly at a new station.
Wow.
That's the power he had.
Now ask yourself what happens to a man who has been sexualized and humiliated like that all his life.
First time I smoked weed was in my backyard here. Got super stoned, and then I realized I liked weed a lot. That's when my desire to smoke weed started, and then I started smoking weed for a while, and then started getting really dependent on it, and that's when I realized that I had to stop. I don't think it's bad, I just think for me it can be a dependency. But yeah, first time I smoked weed, I don't suggest this, but I was 13. Yeah, 13, 12 or 13.
Not sure what I was doing before ya. I quit trying to figure it out.
Was there anything that really concerned me? Yeah, I think maybe the lean when he was drinking that. Can I say that?
There was a time where I was sipping lean, I was popping pills, I was doing Molly, you know, shrooms, everything. And it was just an escape for me. I was just young, you know, like everybody in the industry and people in the world who experiment and do, you know, just normal growing up things. But my experience was in front of cameras and I had a different level of it.
I think when you take somebody very, very young and they start to get horrible, crazy, crippling anxiety and it goes undiagnosed and you don't know what it is that you're feeling, you start to self-medicate because it makes you feel better. Just help you not to feel anything.
with all the success that we've had, we've also had some really turbulent times. When he turned 18, it started bubbling a little bit. 21, that was probably that dark period.
We didn't speak a lot during some of the times where he was running amok. You know, there were a few times where I saw him and it just kind of hurt my heart seeing him the way he was, you know? So I think I just kind of put a little distance with that for my own sake. It would just go without saying that my position on maybe the path he was going down, but at the same time, just letting him live his life and learn, and, I don't know, just do his thing.
I know that Justin knows a good person from a, I don't even know if anyone was a bad person. It was just kids mostly, but like knows good from bad and knows right from wrong. And he's making some wrong decisions, but I never really believed that that person that the whole world hated. So
now all of Diddy's manipulation of Bieber hasn't gone entirely unnoticed. According to Jan De, there is very much a chance that Diddy's controlling persona comes back to bit him in the Diddy.
Now, do you think he has a mole or an informant in his camp that's cooperating?
Oh, no doubt. No doubt. Listen, bro. Just doing law enforcement myself, just take for instance. I think the individual was a Syracuse former basketball player named Jason Barnes or Beard or something like that. He already had drug charges against him. The day Diddy house get raided, they catch him getting on a plane and they put him into custody. Didn't that sound a little weird? People didn't catch that. They either put him in custody for to make a witness out of him or to safeguard him and protect him for anything that could happen to him, because they had already stated, allegedly, that he was some kind of mule for the people over there at Diddy's house. So now, with that information, that he was already known by the government for drug charges, wouldn't that be an individual that you use? I'm gonna give you something Absolutely. Different. And I'm gonna give you something else that people don't even think. On the other day, I seen on the video that Puff had ran into Justin Bieber. They met up and he started tapping him as if he was searching him and see if he had some kind of device on. Check this out. What if the federal government have already talked to Justin Bieber? And Diddy did that on tape. That means in his mind, he think this person may be a witness, right?
Yep.
What he has just done that is against the law?
Nothing that we've seen.
Tampering with a federal witness. If they have already talked to Justin Bieber prior to him doing that, he goes and look like he's searching him. It appears that he's asking Justin Bieber, yo, you got a wire or something like that? Like, you're tampering with a federal witness. That's a charge right there that can land him in jail. Reckless. That was real reckless.
Man, it's gonna be kind of crazy to see everything unfold, man.
Meanwhile, who's been referred to as a mule for Sean Diddy Combs in a recent lawsuit has pleaded not guilty to a drug charge. Brendan Paul's lawyers showed up in a Miami court for his arraignment. Though Paul himself wasn't there, the attorney said, "We entered Brendan's plea of not guilty in court today. We will be dealing with this case in the courtroom, not the court of public opinion." Paul, 25, from Chagrin Falls, Ohio, got arrested in March at Miami Opa-locka Executive Airport while federal agents were searching Diddy's property in Miami Beach and Los Angeles as part of a suspected sex trafficking investigation. Initially, Paul faced two felony drug possession charges for allegedly having cocaine and marijuana candy in his luggage, but the marijuana charge got dropped by the Miami-Dade State Attorney's Office, according to a lawsuit filed by music producer Rodney Jones against Diddy. Paul is involved in getting and distributing drugs and guns for Combs. The suit also claims he's part of a group responsible for paying sex workers in cash. Paul's arrest report says he had the illegal stuff in his personal bags, which he owned up to before being searched. The report, which mentions Miami-Dade police working with the U.S. Department of Homeland Security and Customs and Border Protection, doesn't name drop Combs, who has denied all the accusations against him. The government hasn't said much about the investigation. There are, however, police sources who told the Times that Combs is being investigated for sex trafficking. This is at least partly because of civil lawsuits that several women have made against him for misconduct. Combs has said he did nothing wrong, and his lawyers have said the probe is pointless. A few weeks ago, federal officials searched the artist's homes in Florida and Los Angeles. His lawyer called the investigation a premature rush to judgment of Ms. Combs and said it was nothing more than a witch hunt based on meritless accusations made in civil lawsuits. Still well-known sex trafficking cases from the past could show how the federal government normally builds a case and gives officials hints about what they would need to charge someone. Cassie Ventura, the singer who used to be dating Combs, sued him in November, saying that he had raped her. He got settled in a day. Cam Deal has described what happened to her in horrifying fashion.
So looking at this lawsuit, she alleges that, you know, Diddy, he'll make her look online for BBCs for their freak-off sessions. And she say that, you know, in this lawsuit that, you know, Diddy, he enjoyed watching her get smashed by BBCs. So, you know, what you think about that?
Do you think she was the only one getting banged by him? Do you think this man had this woman search for prostitutes online just for them to have sex with her? It's something fishy about that, bro. Because you gotta realize this lawsuit and the information they had and they gave to Diddy people was 6 months ago. So some of that stuff was cut out. Okay, we're gonna give you this, but you gotta cut this part out. Let's just say, allegedly, or just for the sake of it, Cassie wasn't the only one who wanted, or she didn't want it, but Cassie, who searched for the big black, and she was searching for the big black, not only for herself, but for somebody else who we all know that was in the room with her.
So you feel like Diddy was having sex with the male prostitutes?
They had to be for both of them. They was in the room. Right?
You're right.
It's a freak-off session. Right? She said it's a freak-off session. If she says a freak-off session, brother, she ain't the only one freaking off. The prostitute ain't the only one freaking off. Old boy is freaking off also.
Right, right. So you think he was letting these guys use their BBCs on him?
I think that, and me just being a trained investigator and reading through the lines of certain things, and one time I had read something that Cassie couldn't take it no more. She told her friend, and this was she was under a non-disclosure and everything like that. She told her friend she couldn't take it no more because she had seen this dude do something. I've heard plenty of stories about him being on a yacht. That same yacht that Kim was on, and the same yacht she got her nose broken on, that somebody was doing something to him when they walked in the room
and it caused Cassie may have seen some stuff that she ain't really want to look at. But it was freak off day.
Right, right. And when I look at this lawsuit, man, you know, Cassie, she also alleges that, you know, while she was having sex with these male prostitutes, her, the male prostitutes, and Diddy, they all wore masquerade masks.
He didn't want her to know who they were. So if she ever wanted to do what she just did, how does she say who how the person look? All she could describe is they, if they was wearing masks, unless she saw them before they put the mask on. It's craziness, man. And you know what's so crazy is, bruh, that all these stories has been around the industry for a long time. All these industry people know that Diddy been acting like this and doing this and try to engage other men into sexual acts with a story that he was trying to get Chris Brown. There's stories about, you know, those young boys that he had a group, B5 or something like that, trying to get them. Yo, it's a lot of stories that goes around in this industry about not just him, other people. Jimmy Iovine. Ain't nobody talking about Jimmy Iovine. He got sexual charges and everything on him, but he got those publicists that's keeping it out off of CNN, is keeping it off the major news reports. Nobody's talking about that. This is something that goes on, man, that they're gonna push up under the rug, and a few years later, Bad Boy 5, 6, 7, 8 will be out.
Out, three more women have sued Calm since then, saying say he raped them, sold sex, beat them, and did other bad things to them. One of the claims involved a child. A male director has also sued him for sexual contact that was not wanted, as well as drugging and abusing people.
By Cassie, she claims that, you know, she hid out at a friend's house in Florida after, you know, Diddy put hands on her. And she said that she was tracked down by a guy named James Cruz, the president of Bad Boy Management. You know anything about that?
James Cruz and Hard Pierre always been Diddy's flunkies, especially Hard Pierre. That's why he's being sued right now too by one of his assistants and stuff like that, because I guess he learned from his boss. But James Cruz used to work for 50, but he worked for Diddy first. So them niggas was always scum buckets, man.
So Harvey Pierre, how do you feel about him getting accused of sexual assault?
Like I said, anything that has to do with those sexual assaults, those people have to prove that. But are they capable? Yeah, they're capable. Look at the atmosphere. They in the music industry. They in the music business. They set up those type of, they learn the tricks of the trade. For instance, guys don't put those pills that they get to the girls in the champagne bottles because they popping them in front of them. Most of those girls, especially if they like mixed drinks, you understand, they see the bottles when they open them, and they trying to keep their eyes on because they don't want to get no kind of drugs. But what they don't understand is in the orange juice and it's in the cranberry juice. They done put the pills and the stuff in there, the roofies, the ecstasy, the ease, all whatever they put it in the juice. Now, those girls who like the mixed drinks, you understand what I'm saying?
they gonna pull their own sexual act because they don't understand it ain't in the bottles, it's in the juice. Those guys, they learn that and they put it to those girls who don't know no better.
Legal experts told the Times that there needs to be a lot of proof in sex trafficking cases because the charges can be hard to prove. Sex trafficking for adults usually involves some sort of coercion or other restraints, led defense attorney Dimitri Gorin said. Prosecutors would need to show you encourage somebody to engage in sexual activity for money or some other inducement, in a statement made public after the raids. One of Combs' lawyers, Aaron Dyer, said there has been no finding of criminal or civil liability with any of these allegations. Combs' son, Justin Dyer, Combs' mother, also spoke out against the probe and the raids. The overzealous and overtly militarized force used against my sons, Justin and Christian, is deplorable, designer Missa Hilton said after releasing.